After a few years of work, we've built a whole new version of the Endai 10 for you. The Endai 10 is our workout shoe that's designed for speed work and cross training. As a lightweight trainer, the E10 weighs in at 248 grams or 8.7 ounces in a European size 41. That's a men's US size 8.5 and a women's US size 10. Three areas you'll notice new changes with the Endai 10 is the outsole, the midsole, and the uppers of the E10. Starting with the outsole, we've entirely reworked the outsole to include rubber on most parts of the shoe. The idea here is to increase grip and durability. One such area you'll notice a change is just under your arch, where we didn't have rubber here before. What happened was the midsole, with the old E10s, the midsole stretched more towards this side. So hopefully, with that extra covering of rubber, you get a few more months of use with the shoe. And of course, the fewer shoes you have to buy, the better it is for the environment. Moving to the midsole. The midsole of the Endai 10, we built it to provide a firm and stable base, which is exactly what you need when you're doing heat exercises or when you're lifting weights, or sometimes, you know, mostly when you're negotiating turns. So inside the midsole of the Endai 10, we added this soft pocket of foam that runs from the forefoot area all the way to the heel area. The midsole of the Endai 10 has a 18 millimeter stack height that's measured from the outsole to the insole. It also has a heel to toe drop of 4 millimeters. I know it looks slightly more than that, but then what happens is your foot actually rests deep inside the midsole. The idea here is to provide a cupping effect, which ensures you are comfortably locked in the shoe to avoid slipping sideways, especially when you're taking sharp turns and bends. We've totally reworked the uppers of the Endai 10 as well. We did upgrade to an engineered mesh. We also removed the plastic bulky overlays, and the result of that is a more lighter, more breathable, and of course, durable shoe. On the uppers as well, we removed the lateral seam on the heel area, as well as the seam just on the lateral foot, which to some people, it was uncomfortable. Away from the technical elements, here's my favorite part of the shoe, the cultural elements of the Endai 10. We still call for Harambe, which is a national motto of Kenya, and it means we all pull together. It is also a core value for us at Endai. As runners, we are at our best when we're lifting each other up. On the midsole of the Endai 10, we still have the 12 independence lines or Jamhuri lines. These signify the 12th day of the 12th month of the year when Kenya attained independence from colonial rule. On the eyelets of the E10, which we didn't have before, we added the colors of the Kenyan flag, black, red, and green. On the pull tab, you'll notice 2%, which is a celebration of the fact that 2% of our revenue goes to community development projects in Kenya. On the outsole of the Endai 10, we still retained the repeating Swahili-inspired geometric pattern. You'll also see a bit of that triangulation on the uppers as well. So yeah, hopefully with these few changes of the Endai 10, we hope it serves you as a more durable, more light shoe, and more breathable cross trainer and a speed work shoe.